Number one, this is like public, to the whole wide world, as I told you all, there was a hacking team that was going after Facebook, all right, and they're scripting out to all the kids and everything. And, well, I pretty much do know what the fuck I'm talking about. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna play this piece. And I want you to really pay attention close. This is all about what they're doing to Facebook, this company.
Okay? You've got a company that's about to go through an IPO that's going to raise $5 billion and is going to value it at over $100 billion. We'd be happy about this moment. Inside
So,
Facebook, and
I
especially
mean,
inside
this
the head
is
of
the
Mark
real deal.
Zuckerberg, it's a different picture. They're very nervous that the IPO will actually lead to a dilution of this culture that they've created that has been so effective in getting the company to where it is.
These
Once the
people are
company goes
trained
public,
to
it
do
comes under
this.
scrutiny from Wall Street, which
And
can
these
be
are
a
the
distraction. The
hackers.
stock price can be a distraction. And of course, the incredible wealth that a lot of these employees are going to have can be a factor that stops
And this
motivating
is
people.
only a 2 minute and 34 minute segment from CNN News. I warned you all.
At
You were
Facebook, when they talk
forewarned.
about the
I
hacker wave,
told
they
you.
talk about a culture that is constantly trying to
And you guys
reinvent
are so
itself and
addicted
the
to
products it
Facebook
creates.
and you're being scripted
Whenever a
and you
product is
didn't know
finished,
everything you're doing.
immediately the next cycle begins on how they can make it better. It's all about prototyping ideas. It doesn't matter if the ideas are being created by an intern who's right out of college or a senior engineer. As long as they're good ideas, they'll see the light of day. The company does a
And
deliberate
they're
effort to
taking
instill this
young
into every
individuals
engineer
to
by
do
putting them through a
this.
6-week program called Boot Camp, where they get to hack the code of the main Facebook website and try new things, work on different projects, and the idea is to get everybody familiarized with every part of the Facebook
Now
website.
you got that? They're coming after you. And I think it's best that y'all pay attention.
Hacker
I
culture,
wouldn't
what
take the
matters
time
the
to
most
do
is whether
this.
you can program. So here's a big difference between Facebook and Google. Google famously recruited people, especially in the early days, only from Stanford and MIT and Caltech, and they checked their SAT scores and their GPAs. Facebook was created by a college dropout, and so they're happy to recruit other college dropouts so long as they can code. They bring them in, they put them through an interview where they code. If they pass that interview, they get another interview, they code some more until
And
they have
more.
really proven themselves. And it doesn't matter whether they went to
It's no big
Stanford
deal.
or to a lesser university, if they can code, they have a shot at being somebody at Facebook.
Now, and that's just me, an average engine, as they say, that can find this kind of stuff. All right? Now, I warned y'all. I told you it was coming, and I told you it was here. And you guys just don't want to pay attention to shit anymore. It's like you don't want to know shit about shit, like your president don't want you to know. And there's a lot of bands. I'm Mr. K Colt from CincyLiveRadio.com. And I mean, y'all just really, Ted Nugent, Hank Williams Jr., Toby Keith, Green Day, a bunch of bands, I can only give you so much information at one time on here, okay? And I'm praying to God that this goes through to you. I really am. And we're going to run it live in a second, a couple of these songs. And it's going to start off with Hank Williams Jr., that got fired from Friday Night Football. They literally they fired him on CNN News, a matter of fact. This is directly where it came from, the CNN News. And there was several news articles put out upon it and everything else. And it's coming up within about 10 seconds now. And you heard what they're doing with Facebook. I told y'all, it's not a bullshit deal. I don't give out stupid ass information, all right? And I'm just trying to be straight up honest with y'all. And this is why they fired Hank. There it is.
Try to keep my money and my religion too.
They fired him from Monday Night Football for this song.
Try to keep on smiling.
There's been another band that was banned from China with one song in one day. Now, this next piece that's coming up is done by Ted Nugent. He's 63 years old, been in music business since 1965. It's unbelievable. And it's called Guns and Grenades, okay? And this song that's coming up is literally called Love Grenade. Yeah. United Socialist States of America. And to change. This shit's gotta stop, people. When? When are you gonna pay attention? I mean, music is the universal language of the world. So get it right, man. I mean, if all these people are trying to spit it out to you properly, how come you can't pay attention? Why? I mean, are you that ignorant? I mean, I know none of you are stupid completely. I mean, I've seen some stupid shit on here, but I'll tell you what, you're not all that foolish. And I know you consider me a foolish individual. Because you see me a lot on Blog TV. I go there to play, you know. But I try not to mention no names. I'll make more fun of myself than I do of anybody else. Because if you can't make fun of yourself, don't do it to no one else. That's right. The United Socialists of America. ESPN is the one that he did the live coverage with when they fired him. Poof. Government dumped him. Completely. Totally knocked him off the map. Just for this song. You'll never hear him on the radio again. And y'all ain't never heard his next song on the radio. Well, this is live. Ted Nugent, 63 years old. He has no hearing in his left ear at all. Let the music do the talking to you. Listen up.
Can you feel the love? I got too much love.
And I told you about Facebook being hacked. And what the government's doing to the people. They want you to hate one another. Ain't right. We're gonna have a civil war they wanted. That ain't working, is it? That's why we have war with everybody else. The only reason China don't take us out is because we owe them so much damn money. Think about it. Or can you? Can you think? Or you gotta listen to, you know, Skelter Helter and shit like that that don't know shit about shit. You know, y'all think he's so smart. He's not that smart of a man. He can read. Other than that, he's just a proverb to me. I mean, I find him rather gross myself. So, it's so hard to mix these levels. I really don't want to distort it, but you were forewarned about the hackers. I knew about it a week ahead of time. I was sick. I hit blog, TV, you know, everything else. And what's next? YouTube? Seems awful funny how a lot of people's videos ain't going nowhere. Yeah, and then they've been doing this shit for years. And I'm praying to God that this goes through to you. And his next piece is about the Taliban. And, you know, I mean, you don't see, they don't wear uniforms or nothing. They really don't. As Toby Keith is called the Taliban Song Tribute. You know, this is the way they live. And this is, you know, this is what the government wants you not to hear. This is what the government wants you not to see. Are you getting a point yet? It's all about hate. And all these musicians can put this all together and get it right and try to get it across to you. Why can't you listen? You know, it's just not a lot of music. Stan, I should have used Stan, but I wanted to use grenades instead, you know, grenades, you know, he does great guitar licks, he's 63 years old, he's only gotten better in time, you know, it's unbelievable. There's been a million articles on YouTube about it, you know, his family's been threatened and everything, alright, because of the kind of music he's putting out off this new album called Guns and Grenades, which SinCityLiveRadio.com already owns. You've been found guilty for laying on your fat asses. That's Toby Keith. That's a country boy too. And I'm far from country. I'm a Redskin engine. I ain't no 142% one. I'm just a 100% of my culture. My name is Mr. K, and that's my tribal tattoo, all right? My people prophesized America falling 200 years ago. You guys have done shit on it. Now it's took a shit. And you poor kids on Facebook are fucked. They call themselves the Taliban. You like this? I hope you do. Now I see my wife's face since they came. This is part one. Like a world. Scarf over her head that covers her from ear to ear. She loves the desert and the hot white sand. Man, she just like me. Now she can't stand. and I got two of them, and I got a license to fly them both. I'm not a YouTube freak, but I think something important needs to be said. It needs to be said. Wake the fuck up, you Americans. Colt45_andshit@yahoo.com. You want something to say to me? Come see me. You guys are despicable. Couldn't pay attention to a dick on a dog, much less the words of the song. This is all for you. And I just mean this shit. You guys been asleep too long. You lazy ass son of a bitches. Sit on blog and Facebook and waste your life, and it's despicable. There's a good time and a bad time for everything. Okay? And this is Green Day called Peacemaker. If this goes through, good. I've had these songs. You guys don't listen to shit. You got your little Foxfire, you don't know your plugins, your Google Chrome. You can't plug it into your media default player. You don't have enough brains. You let the computer run you. Learn your damn computers. Internet Explorer came with your computer for a reason. All these wannabe browsers, and you don't even know how to use them. You can't get half the information I get. So, enjoy what's left of your life, because all y'all is working class heroes, is peasants as far as I can see. You haven't even learned how to get to the top of the hill and smile as you kill one another. And you do it every day on blog. You do it every day in your life. You don't even know your next door's neighbor. Love thy neighbor like thy brother. Do you know your neighbor's name? Fuck no, you don't. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope it woke you up a little bit. This is part one.